गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ एच डी पवार, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, गोकटे पी यू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेलगाम. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वॉट इज लॉ ऑफ डिमांड, दैट इज वेन द प्राइस इंक्रीजेज द क्वान्टिटी डिमांडेड इज लेस, एंड वेन द प्राइस डिक्रीजेज क्वान्टिटी डिमांडेड इज मोर. देन वी हैव सीन वॉट इज डिमांड शेड्यूल, दैट इज इट शोज अ लिस्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट क्वान्टिटीज डिमांडेड बाय द कंज्यूमर एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स ऑफ प्राइजेज. देन वॉट इज डिमांड कर्व, दैट इज ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ डिमांड शेड्यूल. Okay, so this is the diagram which shows downward sloping curve, quantity measured on x-axis, price measured on y-axis. So as the price increases, quantity demanded becomes less, and as the price decreases, quantity demanded becomes more, other things being the same. Then DD is a demand curve which is a straight line sloping downwards from left to right, which shows inverse relation between P and Q, that is inverse means opposite relation. Here other things means price of related goods, that is substitute goods and complementary goods. Then income of the consumer, taste of the consumer, all are assumed to be same or constant. There is going to be only change in the price of the particular product. There will be a question, why the demand curve slopes downwards? That is, the reasons are price effect, that is if price is less, he can buy more, and if the price is more, he can buy less. Therefore the demand curve slopes downward. Income effect, now we have assumed income is constant, yet just see, when price falls, the purchasing power of the consumer will increase and he is able to buy more goods with the same amount of money as before. Then next one is substitution effect. If the price of coffee, now coffee and tea are considered as substitute goods, you can either have tea or you can have coffee. Okay, then if the price of coffee increases, what will happen? The demand for coffee is going to decrease, and it will lead to increase in the quantity demanded of tea, because we are assuming tea substitute good prices are constant, only the price of coffee has changed and price of tea is the same. So when price of coffee increases, demand for coffee is going to decrease and demand for tea is going to increase. Therefore there is a positive relation between substitute goods. Then law of diminishing marginal utility effect, that is law of DMU effect. You already know what is law of DMU, that is if a consumer consumes the same commodity again and again, he will get less and less marginal utility from that product. So if the consumer consumes more and more of same goods, he will buy less and less of those goods, because his marginal utility is going to be less, so he will buy less and less of those goods. So he will buy more units of that good only when the price of that particular good has decreased, and therefore demand curve is a downward sloping curve. Now we see relation between income and normal goods. Income, then substitute goods, then complementary goods, these are factors that determine the demand. So we will see relation between income and demand for normal goods. If the quantity of goods demanded increases with increase in income, and if QD of a good decreases with decrease in income, such goods are called as normal goods. That is, it is shown here, M increases, QD also increases. M here income, M decreases, QD also decreases. A person's income increases, he is able to buy more. And if the income decreases, he will be buying less. And such goods are called as normal goods. They move in the same direction. Example, daily goods, necessity goods like milk, fruits, clothes, etc. Then, relation between income and inferior goods. Inferior goods means low quality goods. When the income increases of a consumer, the demand for goods decreases. And as income decreases, the demand for goods increases. Such goods are called as inferior goods. There is opposite or inverse relation between income and quantity demanded of inferior goods. Examples, textbook example is millet or ragi. You can say a person who owns a cycle, when his income increases, he will not buy another cycle, he will think of buying a scooter. Or a person who has a scooter, when his income increases, he will think of buying superior quality, that is, say, car. Okay, so as his income increases, the demand for low quality or inferior goods will become less. Then, relation between related goods and quantity demanded. Related goods means substitute goods and complementary goods, as I have told you before also. Let us see what is the meaning of substitute goods first. Substitute goods are used alternatively to satisfy human wants. That is, examples are tea and coffee. That is, you can either have tea or coffee to satisfy your want. You can use either of them. They are alternatively used to satisfy human want. Other examples can be Coca-Cola, or you can have thumbs up. But you need to take example of tea and coffee as per textbooks. Here, let us see the relation between substitute goods and quantity demanded. If price of coffee, now we are taking the particular product as coffee. If price of coffee increases, then the effect on its substitute good tea will be, that is, the demand for tea is going to increase. That is, if price of coffee increases, automatically the demand for coffee is going to become less. Assuming substitute good tea price is the same, so demand for tea will increase. So, there is going to be positive relation between price of coffee and quantity demanded of tea. That is, price and quantity demanded of substitute goods. There is positive relation. Complementary goods. What is complementary goods? They are when two or more goods are consumed together to satisfy one want. Now say example, textbook example is car and petrol. If you have a car, it's not sufficient. You need to have supplementary good, that is petrol, to run the car. You can give examples like needle and thread, shoes and socks, pencil and eraser. These are complementary goods. Or if you need to drink tea, you need to have tea powder, you need to have sugar, you need to have milk to make tea. Okay, the relation here is opposite, that is, if there is increase in the price of car, what is going to become? When the price of car increases, demand for car will become less. When the demand for car becomes less, the demand for its complementary good, petrol, becomes less. So, if price of car increases, the effect on its complementary good, petrol, will be decrease in demand. So, the relation is opposite between complementary goods. Let us see what is market demand. Now, you have studied law of demand, which says, other things being the same, when the price increases, quantity decreases, and when the price decreases, quantity increases. Then you have seen individual demand curve, that is different quantities demanded by the consumer at various prices and individual demand curve. Now what is market demand curve with the help of diagram? The market demand for a particular price is the total demand of all the consumers taken together, that is the total quantity demanded by all the consumers in the market put together at a given price is called as market demand. It can be derived or it can be got or obtained from the individual demand curves. We go on adding the individual demand curves to get the market demand curve. Suppose, for a simple explanation purpose, assume, think there are only two consumers in the market for a good. Suppose at a price P dash, the demand of consumer 1 is Q dash 1 and that of consumer 2 is Q dash 2. Then the market demand of a good at P dash is going to be Q dash 1 plus Q dash 2. That is the demand of both the consumers put together. Similarly, say if the price is P hat and the demand of consumer 1 is Q hat 1 and consumer 2 is Q hat 2, the market demand at P hat will be Q hat 1 plus Q hat 2. Thus, market demand for a good at each price can be derived by adding up demands of two consumers at that price. This can be explained with the help of a diagram. Now you see there are three demand curves, diagrams shown. The first diagram shows the demand curve of first consumer, consumer 1. Second diagram shows the demand curve of consumer 2. And horizontal summation or adding up both the demand curves will show the third, that is demand curve, that is market demand curve. Now see the first diagram. You see at P dash price the consumer 1 demands Q dash 1, and if the price reduces to P hat, the consumer 1 demands Q hat 1, that is more he demands. In the second diagram, you see when the price is P dash, the second consumer, consumer 2, demands Q dash 2, and if the price becomes less, reduces to P hat, the consumer 2 demands Q hat 2. So that adding up both the demand curves horizontally, then we get market demand curve, that is at P dash you see market demand is Q dash 1 plus Q dash 2, and at P hat the market demand is Q hat 1 plus Q hat 2. Okay, so the derivation, now here you see always quantity is to be measured on x-axis and price on y-axis. So here derivation or obtaining of the market demand curve is the horizontal summation. Summation means what? Adding up of individual demand curves, and we get the market demand curve. Let me continue with explain the movement along the demand curve. Now we see what is a movement along the demand curve. That is, it is when the price change in quantity demanded takes place due to change in, sorry, it is when the change in quantity demanded takes place due to change in the price of the good. Now we have seen quantity demanded depends on the price of that particular product. So price, quantity demanded is a dependent factor and price is independent of demand. So when there is change in the price, quantity demanded changes, other things being the same, that is price of substitute goods, price of complementary good, the income of the consumer, the taste of the consumer being the same, only when there is change in price of the particular product due to which the quantity demanded changes, then we call it as movement along the demand curve. Okay, just see, when price falls, quantity demanded is going to increase, and when the price rises, quantity demanded decreases. The change in quantity demanded is due to change in price, and this change in quantity demanded takes place along the same demand curve. Now observe the diagram here. Quantity demanded measured on x-axis, price measured on y-axis. Now see, given price is P and quantity demanded at price P is Q. Now suppose if the price increases to P1, then quantity demanded will contract, or it will become less. From Q it will become Q1. Then suppose at a given price P, if the price falls to P2, what happens? The quantity demanded will increase from Q to Q2. So here there is an expansion of demand. So contraction, that is the quantity demanded becomes less at high price, and expansion, that is quantity demanded becomes more at a lower price. This change in quantity demanded is taking place on the same demand curve. DD is the demand curve here. The upward arrow is shown as contraction, that is when price rises, quantity becomes less. When price falls, quantity becomes more. Downward arrow is showing expansion. So this change in QD, when price of that particular product changes, other things being the same, is taking place on the same demand curve, is called as movement along the demand curve. I hope you have understood it. Thank you. For today, we shall conclude.